So welcome, welcome, welcome. My name is Tanya Anderson, and I'm the host on Make a Difference. Today we have a amazing speaker. She, her name is, let me give it a shot, Alejandro Di Canirón. Can you please say your name, my friend?
Yeah, it's Alejandra, but you can call me Ale if you would like to.
Ali, perfect. And to the sides, there is the founder of Animal Aware Guatemala. And I have not quite her name down. So can you please say what your name is, my friend?
Yes, I listen.
Okay.
I did not hear that. Oh, it's very loud. It's very quiet. I cannot really hear
it. Shame.
Okay, a little bit better. So today we are getting into to talk about this topic about homeless dog in Guatemala. And that word is a little bit challenging me to say, silly, and adoptions and the main solution to the problem. So yeah, yes. So why I picked this organization, they will talk more into this topic, is because when I was down in Guatemala for 2 years ago, I really saw what was happening for the dogs, the street dogs, and how people was treating the street dog and how they look at the street dog. And I think it was really like, oh my God, that was really touched my heart. And when I find this organization, Animal Aware Guatemala, I really feel there was a need for to bring the awareness around out how we can work with a homeless dog and homeless cats as they work with, and how we can get them this out, adopt them, and really protect them when we travel down to Guatemala, and also get some awareness about homeless dog in general and why it's so important to adopt instead of buying new puppies. So Ella, can you please say, like, where did your passion start for to work with dog and cats? A little bit of background around you.
Yeah. Well, Shani first came to Guatemala in the 1980s. So when she came here, she saw all these problems with homeless dogs and how they were suffering in the streets and how they needed help. So she was one of the pioneers in the country who started this work with animals. And she began with a group of friends, and then when they were like growing in the work they were doing, they were expanding. And nowadays she works with over 400 dogs in the shelter and about 35 cats.
Mm-hmm.
And they do all the process from neuter and spray. They vaccinate, they give them the medicines, and eventually they are suitable for adoption. So it's a lot of work, but it's really rewarding to see how the lives of these animals are changing and how people is reacting to this kind of change.
Amazing, amazing. So as I forget to say that, so Alejandra is volunteer as this organization, Animal Avec. How do you say the middle name of the organization's name?
Animal Aware.
Aware, Guatemala. So where did your passion for to choose to volunteer with cats and dogs?
Yeah, well, I first went to the shelter with my sister because she was very interested in helping or finding some way to help the animals. And there's where we met Shani. And my husband is also an animal lover, so he's always like involved in things with animals. And when we met Shani, we knew that we could help her somehow, and we love animals a lot. So it was like the perfect place to start doing something from our own perspective.
Amazing, amazing. So the first question I'd like to ask you is about what is the three biggest threats or challenges you're facing in your work to work with dogs and cats, street dogs and cats?
Well, I think that the most challenging thing is to find resources to do all this work, because they require like a lot of money to get the medicines, all the care that they need, the food. And So getting the funds to work with the shelter is a very challenging thing. Another challenging thing that I would say it's like how to educate people that how animals need to be treated and that the shelter is not a place just to go and leave a dog, but it's a place where really dogs in need are being taken care of. But it's not just a place where if you don't want your dog, you can leave it there. So it's another challenge. And the other would be like the everyday work, because it's hard work. It never stops. Dogs are always there. They always have needs. So it's real, real work.
Yeah, I can believe that. So how do you deal with this challenge and will it turn around to something powerful or some positive? So you really like stay in the work and really like making a difference for the animals there?
Yeah, I believe that Animal Aware has been a great inspiration in Guatemala because all the organizations that exist nowadays are somehow related to Aware. This was the first shelter that began working with dogs and cats in Guatemala, domestic animals. So this is like the root of every single organization that is working right now. So it's very inspiring to see how it changed all the mechanics in the country. And other thing is that they dedicate a lot of time to educate people how they need to neuter and spay the dogs. That's very important. That's like the first step to really dealing with this problem. And the other challenge, well, is working with big organizations like they can donate the food. And so that is another way to make it better.
Amazing. So in this challenge you're facing, what is the solution you're using to really turn that around?
Well, nowadays, the solution, for example, for the food is working with big companies that can donate month to month. There's also a program where people can adopt a pet without taking them home. It's like fostering.
Oh.
I'm sorry, it's a sponsor. It's a sponsor thing.
Ah, sponsor, that
you can
okay.
You can give like $20 a month and you will be paying for some expenses for your dog or your cat and you will get pictures every month. So this is a great program that is working right now and it helps a lot with funds.
So there is no foster, you do not foster the animals?
No,
okay.
Sorry.
Okay, that's okay, just like clear that out.
Okay.
What else have you turned this solution on? Like here in Denmark, people in Denmark is more like they want a new pup, they want like a new baby. Is that also something you work on to inspire people to adopt instead of buying a dog that have breed puppies? Because I know you have a lot of dogs and cats on the streets and also in your center or shelter that need a home.
Yeah, well, we participate in a lot of adoption fairs and we take the dogs to the places where people can meet them. Also, the shelter is not very close to the city. It's like 40 minutes. So it's not really easy to get to the shelter. So sometimes it's easier to take the dogs to the adoption fairs. And that has worked for some time. And we are also trying to motivate adoption through social media.
Yeah, perfect. That is beautiful. Yeah, to really inspire people. The dogs and cats need a home. There's so many out there that need a home. So where is it in Guatemala exactly? Because I know Guatemala is very big. So where is in Guatemala the shelter?
Well, the shelter is located in a town named Zumpango. It's like 40 kilometers from the city, maybe. You can get there by bus or in a car. There is a nice highway to get there, but it's not like really in the center. It's a beautiful area. It's in a mountain. surrounded by trees, a lot of nature, and it's a really nice place to be.
Amazing, amazing. So with that knowledge you have today, what guidance would you give to the audience to make a change in their lifestyle so the lifestyle can serve your job?
Well, I would say that the most important thing is to be aware that how big a responsibility an animal is. It's not just when they're puppies and they're cute and everything. It's a commitment for a long term. So it's really important to have that in mind when you get a pet and be responsible with the decision that you're making. And if you can help somebody else or you can change the life of another animal, it's a great idea. Adoption is always the first option. I guess there's so many animals in need that there's no need to buy an animal. If you can adopt, that's the best thing you can do.
Exactly. So I'm curious to know a little bit about like how are they, because the team in the Wild Footprints is really inspire people to go out and volunteer, because you learn so much about yourself and like experience so much life. So how is one day, I know this is a freestyle question to my friend, how is one day in the shelter like from morning to evening with around the dogs and the cats?
Well, the work begins really early, and I know Shani wakes up really early to be with the dogs, and she is she's checking that they all get their food. The spaces need to be clean. They also have walks around the woods, so they have like different schedules to walk around, and there are emergencies all the time that some dog is like having some problems, so they go to the clinic. There's a clinic inside the shelter. And basically it's like checking on every dog on the shelter, seeing that they have gotten the food, their medicines or anything that special that they might need. And there are workers too that they are in charge of the cleaning, the maintenance. So it's like, that's the everyday work. And it ends at around 5, 6 p.m. and then another day. But basically that's what they do on an everyday basis.
So it's most the same, like every day, there's no like a day where there's happening something around dogs and the cats?
Sunday is adoption day. So that's the day where people can go and visit the animals. There's also a place, like a little cabin where volunteers can stay. Shani has hosted volunteers from all over the world that stay for 1 week, 2 weeks. So they help with everyday work, and that's basically what they can do.
So how long time is the volunteer staying at the time? Is it only 4 weeks or 2 weeks and he's gone, or can stay there for a few months? Or what is like the requirement for them?
They can stay for as long as they want. We only require that they get involved in the work and that they really love the animals and be willing to help. And that's basically what we need.
Mm-hmm. Oh, beautiful. I'm curious to know, you share a lot of beautiful picture with me, as I also share with people. I'm curious to know, like, share with the audience that did not see the picture here on the Wild Footprints, like sharing a beautiful story, because the picture you share tell me like 100 words. So I'd love to know, like, what is one beautiful story you can share with the audience?
Well, I think that there are many success stories, like some dogs have gotten to the shelter in really bad condition, like maybe you don't even know if they are going to live or not, but with the care and the love, you see how they change, how they evolve and get better. And eventually when they go to a loving home, that's like the greatest success that we can see in the shelter. I mean, that's the main goal. And it happens not so often as we would like to, but there are many, many success stories.
Oh, beautiful. I was curious to know about adoptions. I was close to adopt a dog that was in Guatemala down in the Acas, the organization I work with. And that was not possible because it will take me like over half of a year to really get the dog home. So where is people coming from to adopt a cat and a dog in your shelter?
Well, most of the dogs and cats are adopted by people in Guatemala, but we've also had many cases of dogs going to Canada, the United States, Europe. So we work with a girl that's really good with this work. So she does all the paperwork and works really hard to get the dogs wherever they need it. So we do have that in mind. Mm-hmm.
All right, so it's like close to all over the globe, people can come like adopt a cat and dog.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Interesting, because I have the experience like it was too difficult or too challenging for me from Denmark to adopt a dog because it will take over half of a year and the time
it could
not
be
have
a little, it's a little harder because there's paperwork that has to be done and special vaccines and some other stuff, but it can be done and it is done regularly in a way.
Amazing. So what else? You share a lot of beautiful things and also with me Black States. What is some good advice or good information what you really like to share with the audience around the work you're doing?
Well, I think that the best advice would be, as I said before, to be responsible, because it's so important to really know that you are in charge of a life and that it's meaningful and it's important. And if you take good care of an animal, you will not be causing any damage to your country, to your world. So it's really important to have that in mind. And also the importance of helping. I mean, we know this problem exists, but there are little things that we can do to help, and it is important to do it and to help if we can with money, or if we cannot do it with money, with time, with work, with spreading the word. So many things that can be done to help an animal.
Beautiful. Thank you so much. So sharing Alejandra and Jenny, there was Jenny, correct?
Jenny.
Or here on to Facebook, the link to this video is below this video, all the social media links and how you can find Animal Awake, Guatemala, all the information there. So please go and follow them on all the social media. And also, hit them a message what you get out of this interview. If you have some questions, send them to Alejandra or Jenny, and they are here to really answer every question you have and support you in the right direction. If you have the heart to donate, volunteer, or spread the words, go straight to them and ask for support. They are really here to help you how you can make a difference around your passion, around make a difference for the dogs and the cats. So with that, Alejandra, do you have the last final words? If you like, want to end the interview with some powerful words to the audience?
Sure. First of all, I would like to thank you for giving us the opportunity to spread the word about AWARE and give us the time to tell everyone about what we do. Thank you very much for that. And we are always open to receiving volunteers. We also have this program where you can shelter, where you can sponsor a dog. I'm sorry.
That's okay.
That is a great program that is working for a few years, and you can do it anywhere in the world. That's a huge help for us. And also, if you can, you can always check the webpage or the social media, and you will find pictures of what we are doing and how you can help from anywhere in the world. So we are open to any kind of help, and thank you very much.
You are most welcome. You're most welcome. And to your audience, please hit the link to this video, because it's so important we take some action on to really make a difference, because we are losing 70% of the knowledge we have gained in this interview. So please, I will invite you to act, send them a message or send them a feedback or what you want, like what is come off you. Please act on that right now, because at that point you really take a stand for Animal Awake Guatemala and say this work is important as you are important. So I really invite you to take an action that is, whatever it is, to take action to the last 5 minutes for you guys. With that, thank you so much for being a part of this live show, Make a Difference. And it was a blessing to have you both on the show, Alejandra and Jenny. And please, if there's something I can support you with, please don't hold back and send me a message. And we are here to support you, the team behind the Vale Footprints.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. I will say adios.
Adios.
Adios. And see you on Facebook. Thank you for watching, and see you again soon, friends. Bye, everyone.